Hey, Sashan, what is going on? Excuse the crudity of my audio. You might hear some noise in the background, but that's only because I've turned off my mic filter. Because we might have another voice in the room I want recorded. So I've been working some more on my die roller for the Total Party Skills RPG system. Where's the run button? It's a mishmash so far of Traveler and TPS. So I've been taking stuff from here and moving it down here and doing other things and borrowing buttons and so down here is the new stuff I'm doing, and this is the old stuff which I'm eventually start picking away at. So that's why the interface looks bizarre. Basically, the first thing you have to do to use the buttons, to use any of these buttons, you have to first load a character. So I've got one made here. Their name is Medic Jones. And it loads their body, mind, and spirit attribute scores. It loads their name. That calculates their XP and their movement, how many spaces they can move during combat, their range, how far they can go before they have to take a nap. And after you load a character, usually the first thing you want to do is initiative. So you roll for initiative. I rolled a 9. So it's using mind, and mind uses two dice for this character. So it rolls two dice. And it rolled a 2d6, came out as 9 here. Next thing you do, you choose a difficulty for a task. They're going to be doing something, some sort of action. You got your difficulties for the actions. And then that unlocks this. You can then say what kind of role you're going to do. Is this a body? Something involving the body, the mind, the spirit, for the action. You can also do random because that's a l legacy feature from the Traveler die roller. You can also do unknown. No one knows what the difficulty is unless I go and look in the log. The difficulty is unknown and it's a 3, which is, I think, easy. 3 would be easy, yeah. I still got it. It's still using Traveler terminology in the log, so I'll have to change that so it's got original ideas for what to put in the log. I want to say it also spits the number out down here, the unknown target number. Let's do another unknown. Oh, now the unknown target number is 14. 14 is very difficult. So once you determine, once you're told basically what the difficulty of the action is going to be, it unlocks this. So you want to do something with your body, maybe use some strength. So it rolls three dice, and it rolled a 9, and then it adds 3 to the roll. This is all done under the hood, because then what this does, this gets locked up. You can't go back up here and change your mind. And you pick your thing. I pick strength, and then when I roll, it adds the 3 to the 9, which is 12, and then it locks this up. So you can't go back and diddly dally and da 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 da. So that's as far as it gets for now. I need to take a clear button, one of these clear buttons, move it over here so I can hit clear, and then it resets this guy up here, which would reset this, and then resets this, and I can make another roll. Because right now I'm locked. Unless I think if I load that character in again, maybe it unlocks things. Let's see here. Ooh, I found a bug. I found a bug. I need to clear out these little radio things too. So what did we roll that time? So we rolled a 12 and then it added the 1 for perception. Anyway, so yeah, I got a bug here. I gotta fix this. So once I start doing these buttons down here, it needs to disable this so I can't go back up here and change the difficulty when I feel like it. All right. And of course there's gonna be bugs. I've only been programming this for 2 days now. It usually takes me a week before 90% of the bugs are out. The other thing is the talking.
Average success.
The constant talking.
44, 23, 9, 11.
I'm debating if I should have the voice in this. This is the Traveler Girl. I'm thinking of using the Traveler Girl in the app here, but this app is different though. Traveler always uses 2 dice. Always. Even when it rolls 3 dice, it's really gonna use 2 dice. So the girl doesn't have to say very much.
7, 6, 9.
Now with total party skills, it's more of a pool. I mean, you could be rolling 5d6. I'd have to come up with all kinds of audio effects to get her to say all the different combinations of the die rolls when you're rolling 5, 6, 7 dice. You know, who knows? The permutations are... I don't want to do it. Now, I can just cheat and use the Google voice. But she sounds... Oh, I don't want the Google voice in my games. I don't like using her in my roleplay sessions. I don't like her voice at all. But it's free. Google's voice is free. This other one you gotta pay for that I'm using. Her license expires constantly. What else? I don't need this graph because the graph's gonna be... It's like when I'm doing this, when I'm doing this kind of stuff, the graph is always the same, pretty much.
Average failure.
But again, when I'm rolling down here, the graph is going to be dynamic. I don't feel like doing a dynamic graph. And plus, this is all convoluted. This looks very convoluted. And Total Party Skills RPG system is supposed to be simple and elegant. This doesn't look simple and elegant. This looks like an HP calculator from the 60s. Anyway, enough rambling. I will talk to you later.